IFAKO-IJAIYE TELEVISION. IFAKO-IJAIYE TELEVISION. Bangba la janta awo ki lumo Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade oki ojo teye keye.
To us that they are not overstaffed. Bible said that the political, the social and economic benefits and implication to this is far, far more. Now, this is the election year. This is the last budget that we intend to have before that will usher us in into the election year, which is coming early next year. Again, this is the middle of the year now. Five months is already gone. And the budget has not even been signed. It has been passed. But the asset from the presidency is it. So
that asset is not even guaranteed because
the presidency will still have to go
because
to
the budget has been padded.
Yes. You see, one thing about we'll go to that
later
as regards the padding of the passage definitely has a social, political, economic
because it's delayed.
The delay, the passage definitely because the economic implication is that with this, if it is passed, and I mean as it is passed, if the asset is given now, it will boost the economic activity of the country because there will be enough liquidity in the system.
You see, I want you to make your own of these remarks too, but I want you to address one particular aspect that Congress surely went into. He said most of these MDAs, that is ministry departments and agencies, that they were not cooperating.
Exactly.
In terms of cooperation, what do they expect? Is it exchange of Ghana works, or what type of cooperation?
Well, the delay was, to me, my perspective, it was a deliberate act.
You think?
Yes, it is 7 months. If the president can send the budget to the National Assembly and stays there for 7 good months. And now, immediately that budget was sent in November, at least we saw on the news when Fashola went to defend his own, the minister in charge of three portfolio, and even the minister of finance and the rest, with Ngige, many of them went to defend what they saw. At least I saw that on the news when those ministers went there. So when my comrade said some people didn't show up, this and that.
It's a factor. It is a fact because you see, you are talking about ministries now. You know, this thing is beyond just ministries.
Yes.
Ministries, departments, and agencies.
Yes, and again, you see, if few people did not go to defend or whatever, what I want us to really look into critically is that we don't really have much of media impact on this delay in budget. We don't have the media, no news stations even talk about it. It's just, maybe we just glance through when people complain that, imagine, not in our budget, this and that. The media, even the print media, the electronics media and the rest, they did not really come up with what we, the masses, really expected from them regards to why don't journalists go and investigate, do investigative journalism. What is delaying this budget? Why don't you have that caption on headlines and papers?
We do.
It was not as serious as some relevant thing. Like the last time IGP came up, we saw within 24 hours, we can see how this thing had just been said on all media.
Yeah.
But now we are saying that this budget is sacrosanct, it's very, very important. It's something that the nation needs, even at this critical time, that we have issue of security, economic issues that are biting hard on us, and the budget were kept in the cooler. If what I said is deliberate, it might be deliberate from the National Assembly itself.
Deliberate to achieve what purpose?
And that is question which journalism has to be asking. What is delaying this budget for 7 months?
Okay.
This question is supposed to have been asked. If it is a department in the ministry that is really holding it down, why can't they come up and publicize this is the issue that is affecting the world, this is why this budget has not been passed, but we see them being irrelevant in at times. What is not really important? So, but thank God, at least the last time Saraki and his men went to see the president, they give the president their words that within a certain period that they will pass the budget, and which they did. At least I give that to them. I don't know the discussion Mr. President has with them, but at least for that, they did what we need.
Okay, sure. Let's move to the
that's good.
Right?
Yes.
Okay.
when we come back from the commercial break.
IFAKO-IJAIYE, IFAKO-IJAIYE Television.
IFAKO-IJAIYE TV, IFAKO-IJAIYE TV. IFAKO-IJAIYE. Keep watching. Keep watching.
Keep watching, guys.
Bangba la janta awo ki lumo oluwa lo fi ran wa ade oki ojo teye keye
Assalamu alaikum ya wahsa kuna kallon wani shirin da ake yi akan television ifako ijaye television shine kowa ke kallon yanzu mallan shehu she ka kallo halaji aruna she ke kallo maman kausara he take kallo mama aisha ifako ijaye television take kallo ku kalle ifako ijaye television akan yanan gizo www.ifakoijayetv.com
My name is Akintunde Oluwaseun and I'm a proud stakeholder in IFAKO-IJAIYE Television.
My name is Oluwafunmilayo Oluwole. I'm a proud stakeholder in IFAKO-IJAIYE Television.
Oruko temi ni Sunday Oma Ladeniyi. I'm a proud stakeholder in IFAKO-IJAIYE Television.
My name is Oluwafemi Sewagunmi. I'm a proud stakeholder in IFAKO-IJAIYE Television.
My name is Joseph Olusegun, aka Coded. I'm a proud stakeholder in IFAKO-IJAIYE Television.
My name is Yoda Ojukoya. I'm proud of IFAKO-IJAIYE Television.
My name is Roland Ojukoya. I am proud of IFAKO-IJAIYE Television.
I'm Dr. Samuel Mustafa. I'm a proud stakeholder in IFAKO-IJAIYE Television.
IFAKO-IJAIYE Television, the pride of the people.
IFAKO-IJAIYE, IFAKO-IJAIYE.
IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. Make sure you vote. IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. Make sure. Oh, you come back. Make sure. Oh, kolo lo ni bo mi just the rosary www.ifakoijayetelevision.com.
Thank you. You're welcome back, viewers. You are still on to the program Politics and Perspectives on IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. And we still have our panelists in the studio, and the topic today is the passage of 2018 Appropriation Bill after 6 months submission. The social, political, and economic intrigues and implications. So, the first thing I think the intrigues, then the implications, because there is power play, and that's why we say some people didn't show up to defend their budget, whatever.
I think I have questions. Because from what we've heard from the two panelists, that some MDAs did not show up to defend and all that, what would have been the reason behind it? Why they did not show up? What could have stopped them from showing up? Because this is the first, it seems to be the first time I'm hearing this, that because the MDAs did not show up.
No, it's not the first time.
I know. That is very alarming, most pronounced.
Okay.
What could have been the reason? Because Mr. President submitted the bill since last
year.
Earlier enough. And even if any MDA had stopped or refused to show up to defend their figures, this supposed to have done. They're supposed to have done this within a short while, at least a month or 2 months.
Okay. Comrade Chomi.
Yeah, thank you. Like I said in my opening prologue, the issue is this.
What is it?
When the president submits the appropriation
estimates
to the National Assembly, the National Assembly will now have to devolve into committees, stages. Different committees will now have to handle different items. And when this appropriation gets to the committee level, they have to extend invitation to the head of whatever.
Ministry or
the agenda that is there. Look, the issue now is this, like my co-panelist was saying earlier on. When it's not only the ministers that will come, For example, I just want to cite an example.
Okay.
If EFCC is called upon to come and defend the budget of its own agency,
that's an agency.
And unfortunately, the EFCC chair or acting chair is out of the country and is the only one that will come over to do the defense. At times, you come with your director of finance, director of budget that you know, but in that, you see, the budget was submitted earlier and I will not dispute the fact. Then after that December, the National Assembly went on break.
Okay.
Yes.
We have to consider that one. When they resumed January, they had other issues they were doing. You know, it's a committee issue. I think they only sit probably twice in a week or twice in a week. But having said that, the intrigue here is this. It is an election year budget. And
So they are playing politics with our
budget. They did play politics with this. Because that is the only, to me, I believe that is the only weapon the National Assembly has to trade with the executive. Because when you even consider some of these items, there are some bogus items in which they normally invite them, come and defend this book. Because we now find out, oh, last year, we gave an approval for this. We passed an appropriation, estimated was given to this particular project. Where have you people gotten to? The committee will insist that we want to go and see
what
the level of compliance or completion. And this
which is normal.
Time, you understand? Which is normal for them, their oversight function before they can go ahead. So, the intrigues here now is the implication. Let me quickly go to the
implication.
The implication is that what the executive had planned to execute for this year in terms of capital project, the chances is very slim.
For them to achieve.
You said something just now that before they could pass the bill, that they want to ask questions based on previous bill.
Yeah.
Based on previous budget.
Like for a project.
If this is where I see it, this is my own perspective. If you approve the budget, estimated budget or not, on so-so project, and such budget was, you expected the budget to have been, the project to have been done, executed. Why not check back?
That is what I'm saying.
Okay.
The time of them going to check to verify the fact.
Should that now delay the new budget?
You see, like we said, there's power play.
Okay.
Having said that, there is even power play. So all these factors combined together now led to this delay.
Okay.
That is it.
Okay. Thank you, Comrade. Show me the time. Let's go to Comrade Aichi, to Dion Olambo.
Thank you.
What do you see to the intrigues and implications to the economic life of we Nigerians?
The intrigues is this. I said it earlier that it's intentionally done. That was why those projects that
who intentionally did it?
Those people that might not really benefit from it. I don't know.
The
National Assembly
will say benefit.
No, the other budgets that will be at least we've been having budgets that are being sent to the National Assembly for passage. And we know that it doesn't take longer time like this. No budget has been taking up to 7 months.
No, last time
they
got
last year was
Last year's budget was delayed.
No.
Because it was not quickly sent. Not the one that was sent. And it was with them for 7 months. That's the difference.
Okay.
You know, the budget can be delayed. Maybe the executive did not send it earlier for the National Assembly to work on. Then we have rush or whatever. But this one was sent earlier. At least, and it takes 7 months to stay with the National Assembly. You see, the intrigues and the power play, as you mentioned, is this. What, you know, I always want to talk on the scale of what I have information.
Okay.
I don't want to just say what I don't really have much about.
Mm-hmm.
But an eye-opener for me in this issue is this. When President Muhammadu Buhari came back from the United States of America, I think either he invited the speaker, the Senate, or they went to see him. I don't know who did the invitation. Maybe they seek permission to see him, or he asked them to come. But I know there might have been a strong word from Mr. President, not a threat.
That what?
regards the budget. Okay. That please, if this budget is not worked on, within this period and this period, if you know, I'm not saying it will, I'm not saying that's how it will happen. I'm just saying that most likely that kind of thing can come up. You know, the integrity of Mr. President is at stake.
They can't be taken to them.
I know they can't be taken to them. But he said something that politicians, that all politicians agree. So there must be, because, you know, Nigeria, we should look inward at times when some things happened. This thing has been seated for 7 months. Even the media, you know, I was even accusing the media of not doing much in regards to what is really
going on. Okay, now, what are the implications?
I will say the implication. Now, at the end of the day, few days of its visitation, they promised us right there in the presidency, the Asoro, that so dates, that budget
will be passed.
And they did that. So that means their meeting with the Mr. President has a significant role. As
not necessarily, because maybe the committees were
both of us are guessing. I guess.
Okay.
You guess.
Okay. Now,
I'm not saying that.
There was an harmonization between the rep and the senate. They have to harmonize because when they go.
So all I know is that it has already affected us, and the economy has really biting hard on the populace. So what things that have been passed now, I don't know. Maybe the president will assent or not. Well, I'm not the president.
Because
of the increase and whatever. But what I know is that,
and the increase is huge.
It's huge. 1 trillion, whatever.
No, it's not. It's 503 billion.
Okay, but I jumped to 19 trillion from 18. From 8 to 9 now.
That way. 8 or something.
So now what I'm saying is that it has already bitten us. We've already felt it. And even it makes some people to score the government low. Because it was delayed more than necessary.
Okay. Yes. Okay, thank you very much. Hershel, I think we need to go for a quick break.
We need to go for the break.
We'll be right back.
Have you subscribed to our YouTube channel? If you haven't, please log on to youtube.com and search for IFAKO-IJAIYE Television Blitz. Click the red button to subscribe and do not forget to thumb up. You can also connect with us on any of our social media platforms. Website www.ifakojaiyetv.com, Twitter at IFAKO-IJAIYE TV, Facebook IFAKO-IJAIYE TV Lagos, Instagram IFAKO-IJAIYE TV, email address IFAKO-IJAIYE Television@gmail.com. My name is Mustafa Oladapola. I am host of IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. IFAKO-IJAIYE Television, the pride of a people.
IFAKO-IJAIYE, IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. IFAKO-IJAIYE, IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. Gbangba la janta awo ki lumo Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade oki ojo teye keye.
Viewers at home, yes. Grew your eyes to no other station except IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. That is what everybody watch now. Don't touch the dial. IFAKO-IJAIYE TV at www.ifakoijayetv.com.
Emma wo, IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. Make sure you wo, Emma wo. IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. www.ifakoijayetelevision.com. Thank you.
You are welcome back, viewers at home. We are still on your program, Politics
and Perspectives,
on your favorite channel, IFAKO-IJAIYE Television. The only online digital,
the most reliable online digital television.
Yes, I will be looking at this topic. The passage of 2018 Appropriation Bill, after 6 months submission, the social, political, and economic intrigues
plus implications.
And we've heard a lot from our panelists.
We now want them to give us their closing remarks.
So I think I should give comrade
Anchi.
No problem. Thank you.
You have 1 minute.
Yes, 1 minute. Thank you so much. You see, the implications is this. Already, we've had it very hard in this 2019 in regards to a lot of infrastructural deficits that we had. But still, many of us still have hope that even despite the delay, a proactive government, like the federal government that we had, recently there is Abeokuta, and I think they've kickstarted some work on that. And other works are still going on, pari passu with the delay. But now, what we should just have in mind is that every one of us should try and give the day, this day, government some support. The budget is approved, it has not been assented now, just passed. So what we should be yearning for is that we should not have more delay again in the assent by Mr. President, because he has not said anything about it. So we pray, maybe hopefully this new week, maybe something will kickstart on that. Okay. And we pray we should not be delayed more than necessary.
Okay, we are not even sure if the budget has been transmitted to the presidency. Because one thing is for it to be passed, another thing is for it to be transmitted to the presidency. So,
yeah, thank you very much. My own take is this. In as much as appropriation bill, the appropriation is just, the budget is just an estimate.
Yeah.
People are getting worried about the upward review by 500 billion.
Mm-hmm.
The president, I'm very sure, will sit back and look at it when it eventually gets to his table.
Okay.
He can as well jettison the review upwards, and he can as well, if within, it's within his prerogative. But I just wish the president will assent to it on time, because the time is far spent.
Yes.
Our budget cycle is January to December. We're already in the fifth month now.
Almost to the end of the month.
And like you said earlier on, the infrastructural decay that we're experiencing. And
a lot of contractors are being owed.
Yeah, since the campaign, like that's why I said, that's political education.
Yeah,
that is what the government will use in campaigning in a few months time. The campaign will start earnestly. So we just hope and that the passage and the final assets will boost the economic activities of the countries, because there definitely there will be money in circulation. So that's just it. Thank you.
Okay, we can only thank these people. But can we thank them
we
enough?
Thank them enough.
Thank you very much,
sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much,
sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Maybe I should thank you too. Okay. You see, we did your own feedbacks. Your feedbacks in terms of your own perspectives. We have Comrade Onolapo's perspectives. We have Comrade Shumi's perspectives. We have Comrade Shimon's perspectives.
Yes.
I have my own perspective.
Yes.
What are your own perspectives? So let us have your perspective. And how do you get it to us? Our YouTube channel, go to youtube.com, search for IFAKO-IJAIYE Television Glitz. And you see, subscribe, just click on the red button. You understand? And you can also make your comment on your comment. Give us thumb up. And if you are not doing well, give us thumb down. Do you understand? So it's allowed. So,
and also, you can send us messages, you can send us your perspectives on our website.
Okay.
Which is www.ifakojaitv.com.
And on Facebook, our Facebook account is IFAKO-IJAIYE TV Lagos.
Also on Twitter, at IFAKO-IJAIYE TV.
Instagram, IFAKO-IJAIYE TV.
Email, IFAKO-IJAIYE television@gmail.com.
And in case you want to give us a call, or you want to send a WhatsApp message to us, our phone number 005-196-4461. The number again, 005-196-4461.
And also 0703-743-9891. 0703-743-9891.
And we need to show appreciation to all of you at home. You are so wonderful. We appreciate you. We thank you for staying tuned from time to time. And we want to also give credit to the people behind the scene. You don't see them, but you cannot underestimate what they are doing to get this program across to your homes. We want to thank Sewan Femi Peters.
And also Emmanuel Aruboto.
And evangelist, ladies evangelist, Milayo Oluwole. We also have in the studio
Samuel Fallo.
Thank you very much. We'll see you next week on another topic on your lovely program, Politics and...